Can you tell me about the rural livelihood?
Sure. There are many occupations that people follow to earn a living. Even the villagers do some jobs to earn a living. Could you name some?
Maybe agriculture and farming.
That's right. So in rural livelihood, we learn about the different ways in which people earn their living in the villages. In a village, there's a small group of people who own large areas of land. They are rich farmers and have a lot of money. They don't work on the land themselves, but employ landless peasants to work on their land. They use modern machines to increase agriculture production. Now, let's hear a story. She and her friends saw a big field with crops ready for the harvest. Everything looked lush and green. Many laborers were working on the farm. Watching the proceedings was Babulal, the owner of the land. He said proudly,
"Hello, my name is Babulal. I own 30 acres of land. I grow sugarcane, which as you know is a cash crop. This enables me to gain a rich harvest every year. I sell my harvest for a very good price. I am able to use tractor and fertilizer for my cultivation. I also hire labor to sow and harvest my crop. Recently, I took a loan to build a tube well to help me in irrigating the field. I am glad that I am able to modernize my farm."
There is another group of people who can grow only few acres of land. They cultivate the land themselves. They grow only a few types of crops on their land. As the work on the land is seasonal, these farmers go to cities to sell vegetables till the crops on their lands are ready. Weeding, hoeing and milling on the farm are mostly done by the women. These farmers are always indebted to the money lenders in the village because they borrow money from them to buy seeds, fertilizers and pesticides, and also when their crops fail due to scanty rainfall. Let's hear another story.
Wow, another story. Let's hear it. You could surely be a storyteller.
About half a kilometer later, Shri and her friends saw small patch of land being tiled by a couple. They stopped to talk to them.
"Hello, we are Palu and Suraj. We own this small patch, which is about an acre. We cultivate all types of crops on it, such as tomato, carrot and maize. Since we are not rich, we cannot afford pesticides or modern tools. We are able to grow just enough for the needs of our family. We have a little left over, then we sell it in the weekly market. We depend on a lot of the annual monsoon because it is our main source of water. If the monsoon fails, then we are in trouble. So our life is constantly in the balance."
So farmers with small land holdings could have completely opposite lifestyle in the same village.
Yes, absolutely. There is another group of people who work on the land that belongs to the other people. They are landless peasants. These peasants work for long hours in the fields in tough conditions. As the work is seasonal, they are without work for a large part of the year. They are mostly not educated. However, some of them try to take up other jobs like working on construction sites, doing some carpentry work and getting engaged in fishing, mining, forestry, animal husbandry, etc. Let me tell you another story. Some children were walking and they saw a thin, frail man walking home with his donkey. They wished him and asked, "Can you tell us about yourself and how you earn your living?"
"Yes, my name is Mahi. I am a poor peasant who has no land, so I need to work on farms of others. I get work only during the sowing and harvest seasons. I am paid a daily wage. God forbid, if the monsoon fails or there is a drought, then my family and I are penniless because there is no work. At other times, I go around looking for odd jobs, but there is no much to do because this is just a small village. There are times when we have no food, absolutely nothing,
we are still paying back the loans that my father took from the moneylender. He has already taken away our 3 acres of land and all my wife's jewelry. I often wonder how our 4 children will survive.